first I want to start by praising our team for last night's win. I think a lot of people and a lot of our players could have used excuses with how our lineup is depleted. And the character of a few certain of our players really showed last night. I think you look at Eric Carlson, the way he stepped up. It's tough for me to argue with people, but at the same time, when people say he's not the best defenseman in the league, if not one of the better players, I think we saw it last night. I think the way Craig made many quality saves was also another indication of how our team is resilient. At the same time, I just want to also talk about, I think Curtis's game last night was one of his better, maybe playing the wing, maybe easier for him, maybe taking a bit of pressure off him. I think that line of Wingles, Kelly, and Lazar gave us really important minutes, and that's something to look forward to as we move along in this playoff stretch. I also just want to make sure that everyone's clear on the injuries. As far as Bobby Ryan, we know he doesn't need surgery. We think he'll be about a month, so we know he'll be back for the last few weeks of the year. After that, we're hopeful, but probably doubtful for both Mark Stone and Mike Hoffman for Friday. I think we're, if everything would go well, it'd be either Sunday or Monday for both cases. If either one plays before that, I think it'll be a bonus for us. We got a few little bumps and bruises from, you know, the hectic schedule. But at the same time, I think our guys are playing. A lot of our guys are playing through injuries, and I'm sure a lot of teams go through it. But I know a lot of guys are playing in pain, and they have to be commended and credited for being able to play through that pain.
You got to look at your depth last night as well with the two call-ups. How would you assess the performance of Max and Casey?
I thought both gave us good minutes. I didn't like one turnover.
Yeah.
I don't think the coach liked one turnover, but it's experience. You know, I think after that he was all right. I really like how both played in the first 10 minutes. Maybe it was the energy, the testosterone, but I thought both gave us scoring chances in the first 10 minutes. I think Bailey was pretty consistent through the game, and I thought Max battled and played hard.
Are you hopeful that Hoffman skated yesterday? Are you hoping that Stone can skate tomorrow?
We hope, but we never know. It's a pretty serious neck strain.
Okay.
So we're going to take our time, make sure that both players are healthy. I would say that it's not a 100-meter race till the end. It's a marathon, and we'd like to have our players be able to do the whole marathon.
And with, I would think with a groin with Hoffman, that's the case too, right?
Yeah, like we're going to
better rest.
Yeah, better rest and make sure that everything is good. And on both those guys, we're going to make sure that they might not play at 100%, but closer to 150.
Just on Lazar, you kind of talked about this on TV a little last night, but what's his situation and what was said in that meeting with JP?
First, he paid, which is good. Second, when it came to that meeting, it was just more about his role. And from day one here in Ottawa, I think both Randy and myself have said that the coach is going to decide the minutes of the players. It's up to the players to earn their minutes. And Curtis, having the mono, then going to bingo, being behind the eight ball from the start of the year, probably hasn't found his niche with our team. Now he's getting a really good opportunity, and hopefully he can keep on improving his minutes, but it's going to be up to him. But definitely last night was a sign in the right direction.
A week away from training deadline, what's your approach and what would you like to do?
Well, it's no secret. I think we're pretty set as far as goaltending. I think we're pretty far set on defense. I think our coaching's pretty good. We're not going to make any changes there. So if we could, and especially with the roster of injuries now, we probably have to look at, if we were going to do something, to look at the forward position. For us, improving that depth, even though I'm happy with what we saw yesterday, you never know how you can lose guys quickly as we have lost guys. And with having Bobby out for probably about a month, trying guys might not be the worst thing, but trying guys at this time of the year is probably the worst thing to do because you need those points every night. So for us, we're going to, if we do anything, and the way things are going right now, the market still is establishing itself, whether it's for rentals or whether it's for hockey trades. So there's a good chance that we go into after March 1st with the same team we have now. We'd like to do something, but we can't, as I said, whether it's rentals or just a hockey trade, you got to give up something. And, you know, being a first-year GM, it's tempting. We could give up a great asset for the future, but I think we owe it to the organization. When those players are going to play, whether it's next year, 2 or 3 years, how good they're going to be, you can't do that, you know. So that's why right now we're at a point where we might just stay with what we have.
Does having Bobby on IR give you more flexibility financially to make a move?
No. No. Mr. Melnick has told me from day one, do what you have to do to get this team to the playoffs. So, to me, it's not even an issue.
Is there attractiveness as far as a rental player is concerned? Are there players out there that you have an interest in?
Well, there's always attractiveness, but the problem is trying to get them. Mm-hmm. No. We'd all like to add 5 All-Stars at the trade deadline, but that's not going to happen. I've talked to my counterparts. I think yesterday at the game, I think I've talked to 12 GMs in the last 48 hours or a bit more than that in the last 2 to 3 days. So at the same time, you're telling yourself you're trying to work the phones, you're trying to make deals, but making deals is much harder than people think it is.
How did the expansion draft influence the decisions you make this week?
Every decision that we make this week is influenced by the expansion draft. We know where we stand. We have a good idea what route we're going to take when it comes to protection. I've done now 4 mock drafts. If I was Vegas, you know, because it's not just who they're going to take from our team. Is they have a certain number of rules. They have to take a certain amount of forwards, certain amount of defensemen, certain amount of goalies. So it's trying to balance it, you know, making sure where they fall, you know, what direction they're going to go with how much money they're going to spend. So, and that could influence a lot of things you do. So that part about it is, I think a lot of what we do this week is influenced by the expansion draft.
You said last week that you were talking to Connor and Pyatt. Any chance either of those guys will be signed before the deadline?
No.
But you said you aren't going to trade them either?
No, I'm not trading either one of them. No, they were here with the team. They're here till the year. I think when you make commitments to players, you honor them. Both have been important parts of our team this year. I think those are matters for after the trade deadline, after March 1st.
You have to resist the urge to make a deal.
You're putting it perfectly, Bruce. Resisting the urge to trade someone that you know will be a really good player, whether it's next year, the year after, 3 years down the road, 4 years down the road, is very tough. And team scouting now is so good that I get calls on probably the same 5, 6, 7 guys. And you know that, you know, whether we have 5, 6, 7 guys that will play for us at whatever degree, it's tough because you want to help this team. The one thing is this year is our players have bought in. They've done a great job. They've done things that I haven't seen in the last few years where they're committed to winning, and you want to try and help them. You know, that's why we went when Andy had to leave the team. We went and got Condon. So in that direction of it, for us, of course, you want to try and help them as best as you can. But at the same time, you have to do what's right for the organization, you know, in the short, medium, and long term.